basic concepts of loader and the one loader scheme, that is a compile and go loader, in this video. So what is basic concepts of loader? Loader is a program which accepts object program deck prepared by another converter, or we can say assembler or compiler, and that object file will get loaded into main memory. This is the main functionality of loader. So loader is a system program that performs the loading function. Loading is the process of placing the program into main memory for execution. Again, loader is responsible for initiating the execution of process. So simply, loader is nothing but loads object file in main memory for execution purpose. So in this diagram you can see translator. So this translator may be compiler or may be assembler, which will convert source program, high level program or the assembly program, it will convert into object program, and that object program loader load into main memory at given location in main memory. That location may be given by assembler or may be given by the programmer. So functionality of loader is to load that program, object program, into main memory. So this is a role of loader. What is a linker? Linker is again system program which will combine one or more object file in one executable program. So in loader, linking is also done. Now here you can see in this diagram overview of linker and loader. So translator, again it may be compiler or the assembler, which will convert source program to assembly language program or in another language. Again, linker will link one or more subroutines or the functions or the objects. That is the functionality of linkers. Resolve some symbolic references by linker and convert one executable file. That one executable file will be passed to the loader, and loader will load that executable file into main memory. So this is what the functionality of linker and loader shown in this diagram. So this is a data flow, means from different data structures are used to resolve symbolic references, or there are some internal variables or the external variables. So all the information is stored in different modules or the data structures. And control flow means from one system program to another system program. These are the different system program: translator, assembler, linker, loader, all these are system programs. Now, functions of loader. So loader is responsible for main four activities. First is allocation, second linking, third is relocation, and finally loading. So what is a allocation? Allocation is nothing but calculating size of program so that how much memory is required to store that program in main memory. Means how much bytes of memory required to store that program in main memory. That is nothing but allocation. Linking is nothing but resolving symbolic references between different programs or subroutines. Means there are some variables which are external variables. So resolving addresses in the linking section, so that linker or the linking activity is done, and we are getting only one executable file. Then relocation. Meaning of this is, let us consider by assembler or the by translator, one address is given, at that we have to load that program. But In main memory, that location is allocated for some another purpose. So we cannot load, or loader cannot load that program in specified location. So relocation is done. Means we can loader is relocating whole program at another address in main memory. That is called a relocation. So corresponding allocated space is not available. And finally, fourth functionality is loading in main memory. Means that one object file will load into main memory for execution purpose. So this is the functionalities or four functions of the loader. Now there are different loader schemes. We are going to see these six loader schemes in different videos. So in this video we are going to see compile and go loader scheme. So compile and go loader scheme. As name given, compile and go loader means here you can see in this diagram source deck program or source program. This program is going to convert in object code, and that object code how to load into main memory. This is the functionality of loader. So here assembler is loaded in main memory, and that assembler convert source program in object program or the machine code, and loader take that machine code and load into main memory. So this is the functionality, or this is the working of compile and go loader. That means assembler runs in one part of main memory, as shown in figure. Assembler runs in main part of memory, convert one by one instruction into machine code, then loader will take that machine instruction and load into the main memory. Then this loader is also called as assemble and go, because assembler is working simultaneously. That's why compile and go loader, also known as assemble and go loader. So typical example of this is Water for 77. It's a Fortran compiler. Over there, compile and go loader scheme is used. Now there are some advantages and disadvantages of compile and go loader. So we'll see advantages. This is very simple and easy to implement, because assembler is loaded in main memory, convert that program into machine code, and loader take that machine code and simply load into main memory. Because of assembler is placed in one part of memory, loader simply loads assemble machine instruction into main memory. This is again second advantage. No additional routines are required to load the compile code into main memory. Directly assembler's machine code is passed to loader, and loader loading into main memory. So no additional routine is required. So these are the advantages. Now there are some disadvantages. So first disadvantage is there is a wastage of main memory, because assembler is taking some part of main memory. So this is a main disadvantage of compile and go loader. Second, we cannot handle multiple source program in this type of loader. Means only one source program, that source program will get converted into machine code by assembler and loaded into the main memory. So we cannot handle multiple programs simultaneously. This is the second disadvantage. Then the execution time is more. Why? Because assembler is working, then passing to the loader, and loader is loading into the main program. So it is a more time consuming. And one more disadvantage is no modification in the source program, because assembler is working simultaneously. So every time object file is done by the assembler and then loading into the main memory. So it is again time consuming activity. So these are the disadvantages due to this assembler is working together. So assembler is taking extra part of memory which is loaded into main memory and taking extra memory as well as extra time. So these are the advantages, these are the disadvantages. So in university exam, these are the some questions which are asking. So first define loader, enlist basic functions of loader scheme. So you can draw a diagram here and four basic function already we discussed. Then define loader and explain its function. Again this is the same question but in another way. Write a note on compile and go loader or assemble and go loader. Sometimes they may ask assemble and go loader also. Also sometimes discuss advantages and disadvantages of compile and go loader. So first what is write down what is compile and go loader and then write down the advantages and disadvantages of this scheme. So this is what about loader scheme. You can see different videos on system programming in my channel. If you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe my channel. Thank you.